I'm working on this booklet about Cuba from pictures and text from my recent visit there. And I'm looking at this one paragraph with these fractions. I want to show you how to create beautiful fractions in your documents, not these kind of things, which look like they were created in, you know, in very old version of PageMaker or something like that. I mean, even Word will often convert ugly fractions like this into nice ones with numerators and denominators. Now, there's a couple ways to do this. First of all, a lot of modern fonts have beautifully set fractions already built in, and you can find those by looking at the Glyphs panel. The Glyphs panel is found in two places, underneath the Type menu, Glyphs, and also in the Window menu down under Type and Tables, Glyphs, same thing. And it shows you all of the glyphs, that is the characters, the correct name is Glyphs, in that current font. So the current font here is Caslon Pro, where my cursor's blinking. I can choose different fonts if I wanted to, but what I'm looking for, usually it shows you something like this, entire fonts. And you have a bazillion glyphs to look at. What you want to do is come to this drop-down menu where it says Show and see if there's something here that says fractions or numbers or something like that. So you see there's, depending on the kind of font that you've chosen, if it's OpenType or TrueType, you might see fewer categories than this. But here we have numbers. And so these are all the different kind of numbers. See, they have separate numerators and denominators, but down here they actually have some built-in fractions. So instead of 2/3, and while this panel is open, you can go ahead and edit your text, I could just type double-click on 2/3, which is a much nicer looking fraction, isn't it? So I'll delete that one. Now what about 4/17? Well, most fonts don't have 4/17 built in. You're lucky if you get 1/2, 1/4, and 3/4, and bonus if you get 1/8 and 1/3, but this one you're not going to have. So that's when you're going to hope that you're using an OpenType font, which Adobe Caslon Pro is, because most of those fonts have OpenType fractions built in. What you do is you select the fraction, and you can see that InDesign is already suggesting you probably want this fraction. This is a new feature that they added in, I believe, CC 2017. If you don't have this feature, I can just select it and you see that it replaces it. I'm going to undo. Then you can go to the OpenType menu in the control panel here, the very first item. And if fractions does not have the brackets around it, brackets means that that kind of thing is not available in this particular font. So Adobe Caslon Pro doesn't have any fancy swashes. But fractions is working. Choose fractions and it sets that up as a fraction. So there's two ways to get nice looking fractions in your type. Look in the Glyphs panel or use OpenType fractions. I hope you found this tip helpful. Be sure to check out InDesignSecrets.com for thousands of InDesign articles and tutorials and to download a free sample issue of our monthly magazine called InDesign Magazine. Thanks for learning with us.